Justina!
Justina!
Stephen, how do you prepare for a game?
Well, just wake up in the morning with Weet-Bix, cornflakes, something like that, breakfast. And then before a game, I usually pray before I chuck that shirt on me. Yeah.
When you get out there, what is the feeling that you feel?
I feel nervous, but really motivated. Pumped to play.
What does the haka mean to you?
Haka to me, or I think to everyone on the team, means a lot to us. Like, the haka is what gives us more
intensity,
things like that. Pumps us up.
Insanity at its finest. Firestarter, riot maker, moonstricken, animal need, bad seed, untamable.
Everybody around me always think they know what's going on inside my mind. Think I'm Mr. Nice Guy all the time. How they say on diary, you think you know, but you have no idea.
CMO is with me, let's make more growth. We will be shaking your flow. Come against me, that's a no-no. Yo, cause I'm a beast.
I can tell you.
I've always enjoyed it. I love college rugby. I think it's the pinnacle of rugby up until you become a professional. I think it's the reason why New Zealand rugby is so strong.
Please, you get a trophy. How does that feel?
You're always disappointed. You're gutted for the players because they don't get to experience what it's like to win and get to read what's inside the trophy. And for a lot of it, for most of the boys, in fact probably all of the boys, that's the biggest game of the year and one that they focus on and think about for a long time. So to come up short is disappointing. Would you probably feel you played the better rugby? Hopefully the unluckiness comes back to in our favour at some stage because we had a couple of calls go against us.
Well, at the start of the year, then we started to start losing our games. What do you think the causes of that was?
I think there were a few things that contributed to that. Not having surge throughout that middle part of the season was a big loss for us. I think he added a lot, and he would have he made trainings a lot easier, took the pressure off me a little bit, and the boys responded well to him. So not having him for the second half of the year affected us. A couple of injuries, and the other thing is just a lack of discipline, which was on. We had a lack of discipline on and off the field, and we couldn't quite get there right, and so I'll probably, you know, it'll ref- affliction, take responsibility for that, and didn't create a disciplined side, which you need to be. And if I compare us to Villard, they were disciplined this year. So in the past, we've always relied on their ill discipline and banked on us being disciplined and then giving away some penalties and some cards and knowing that that would get us home. And we almost traded places with them. We had a lot of boys in trouble at school and that flowed through into the rugby.
And drive-bys, ride my homies of the young lives. I never did cry, and even though I had pain in my heart, I was hopeless from the start. They couldn't tell me nothing, they all tried to help me. The marijuana had my mind gone, it wasn't healthy. I dropped places, cold cases, what a deal, yeah. I felt the pain and the brain, but I'm still here. Never did like the police, let the whole world know. Now I get no peace, cause they're chasing me down. And facing me now, what do I do? These things that a thug goes through. Still I rise, so keep your head up and make your mind strong. It's a struggle every day, but